Dwayne, have you come to the reaction video? New championship that sub on the smash that notification bells. Alright, so we got the Bosnian War, the death of Yugoslavia History Channel doc. Now, this spawned on me because I was talking to someone who's from Bosnia, and I thought she was mixed with Salvia or Slovakian or something like that. But it was it Yugoslavia? I was saying it wrong. I knew it had something to do with connection. So then she was just telling me that they were all together, but it split up. Them, Serbia, and I think there's two other more. But we're about to find out what really technically happened in this war. We're about to find out now. This is nothing to play with. A lot of people did die. I know back in like a couple of years ago, not thinking about it, there was a guy, like an old guy, I think he was on trial for one of these deaths, and the guy, I guess, got convicted like 20 years? Yeah, I think 20 years. I can't remember, it was an old video. But he ended up drinking poison. You guys probably find it on Google or some shit. But you guys already know the drill, it's a long vid, 48 minutes, so go get your drink, go get your food, go get you what you need to get through. Let's get into this tragedy, man. RIP to the lost souls.
We are not supporting any military action in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
We were not provoking or supporting hostilities.
Serbia's President Milosevic has repeatedly said that the conflict in Bosnia was a civil war for which he could not be blamed. But the men in charge of the murder and ethnic cleansing in Bosnia now describe his role.
Tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci. Mislim, to nas nije trebalo ubeđivati mnogo.
Predsjednik Milošević nije smatrao da je samo priznanje, međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine nešto presudno.
Jugoslavija. You guys are playing chess, see? So it's Croatia, but Gates of Hell, okay.
The Muslims of Bosnia felt threatened. As Yugoslavia collapsed, they faced domination
religion.
By their neighbor,
religion
Serbia.
Moram reći ovdje otvoreno. I bet you this fight had to be some new religion. Once out of all religions, Muslims get it bad, like black people back in slavery. I swear, like, if you're a Muslim, bro, you're Muslim. It's like you can't be Muslim. In China, you can't be Muslim. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but just every time I hear somebody Muslim, it's just never good for Muslims, bro. Never good for Muslim people. Oh, shoot, didn't even want.
But Izetbegović didn't speak for all.
That's like Quebec in Canada.
A third of them were Serb. They wanted Bosnia to stay in Yugoslavia, where most Serbs lived. In parliament, their leader issued a black warning.
Nemojte da mislite da nećete odvesti Bosnu i Hercegovinu u pakao, a muslimanski narod možda u nestanak. Jer muslimanski narod ne može da se odbrani ako bude rat ovdje.
Evo, umjesto gospodina Janović, gospodin Izetbegović.
Ja sam, osjećao sam da se približava pakao ovaj i kao da su se vrata pakla na trenutak, otvorila i kao da jedan jezik onoga plamena malo prešao preko ni svih u nas u tom trenutku.
Njegov način izlaganja, njegove poruke, možda na najbolji način objašnjavaju zašto mi i možda nećemo više da ostanemo u Jugoslaviji. To večeras govorim ovdje.
But I don't get why they split him. Why do they want to split?
I još nešto. Takvu Jugoslaviju kakvu hoće gospodin Karadžić više niko neće. Neće više niko možda osim srpskog naroda.
Očekivao sam da će doći do sukoba, ali nisam očekivao genocid.
Genocid, ooo.
For centuries, Muslims, Serbs and Croats had lived here together. Now they had to choose a future. Half the Yugoslav republics had gone for independence, and it was time for the Bosnians to decide.
Governmentship. It's just governmentship, basically.
Mi smo sami sebe doveli u situaciju u kojoj više nema
zajedničkog života. Territory control.
Potpuna, gotovo 100% odlučnost Srba je da ostanu u Jugoslaviji. A gotovo 100% odlučnost Hrvata ima da napusti Jugoslaviju. Tu se jasno vidjelo da Bosna ne može da opstane.
President Izetbegović called a referendum on independence. Muslims and Croats were the majority. So the president won his vote.
So we are expecting the very fast recognition of the republic.
He was expecting trouble, but he didn't know it would start from his own side. It happened as the guests arrived at a Serb wedding.
Ooh, drive-by?
A Muslim killed the father of the groom. That night, Serbs hit back.
Oh, it's a random person.
Their gunmen erected armed barricades all over the Bosnian capital.
Zahtjevi srpskog stanovništva iz Sarajeva. Pod jedan. Da se bezuslovno obustave sve aktivnosti od strane predsjedništva Skupštine i vlade BiH na međunarodnom priznanju suverenosti i nezavisnosti Bosne i Hercegovine.
Neither the Bosnian police nor the Green Berets, the Muslim paramilitaries under Izetbegović, were strong enough to take on the Serbs.
Yeah, when you don't smoke all day and this shit's starting to kick, oh my god!
Pa smo se odlučili da ne primijenimo silu. U protivnom, došlo je vjerojatno do uličnih borbi u dijelu grada u kojima mi nismo imali dovoljno naših snaga da uspješno izvedemo tu
akciju. I feel sad. You know what it's gonna lead to.
The streets of the capital fell into the hands of the rival militias.
Anarchy show.
The Muslims held the city center. The Serbs, much of the rest, including the strategic heights, on which they placed heavy weapons.
But they keep saying Muslim.
The people of Sarajevo saw a war looming and begged their leaders to prevent it.
Adding the ammo, eh? But they keep saying Muslim, not like Bosnia. So is it Serbia and Muslims, or Muslims from Serbia, Muslims from Bosnia?
Predsjedniče Izetbegoviću, kao ljudi koji predvodite dva naroda, vi znate koja je u ovom trenutku vaša odgovornost. Mi apelujemo u ime javnosti koja se javlja masovno telefonima i koja predlaže vaš sastanak.
The two leaders agreed to meet at the headquarters of the Yugoslav Federal Army in downtown Sarajevo.
Bila je, naravno, ledena atmosfera, bilo je već jasno da su događaji otišli predaleko.
To je takva svađa bila da se oni jedan drugom unose, pesa rukama u lice. Znate, ja tebi, ti, meni, tako dalje. Tako da sam ja morao to malo da razdvajam.
Zadržali smo se jedan sat i kao zaključili da se sukob spriječi. Te večeri je taj sukob bio izbjegnut. Saglasili smo se da sigurnost grada i građana predamo u ruke mješovitih patrola, vojske i milicije i policije u stvari. Mješovitih patrola.
The Bosnian Serb leader Radovan Karadžić had not really backed down. He knew that his patron, the Serb president Slobodan Milosevic, and the president of neighboring Croatia had agreed to carve up Bosnia. Rumors of this Serb-Croat deal have long circulated.
Oh, didn't he say they had partnered up with what? Should I go back too far?
He knew that his patron, the Serb president Slobodan Milosevic, and the president of neighboring Croatia had agreed to carve up Bosnia.
Jeez,
rumors of this Serb-Croat deal have long circulated.
Set up
now,
team.
Now, those involved in the talks tell what happened.
Rješenje ono što sam ja predlagao za čitavu Jugoslaviju, da se Bosna i Hercegovina organizira kao konfederacija triju naroda, da bi sva tri naroda bila zadovoljna. Drugo rješenje je da se ide na, na podjelu.
Tudjman now went for partition.
Puške na rame. Nadesno.
They had to set
in his capital, he initiated a series of secret meetings between the Bosnian Serbs and his clients, the Bosnian Croats.
Shvatio sam da su se Srbi i Hrvati u Bosni i Hercegovini dogovorili.
All right, that just confused me, man. Why for that? Bosnian Serbs and what? They're not Serbian? So you're telling me basically, this is like Toronto. Oh, well, friend, my Canadian. So like, it's like Toronto beef in Mississauga, while beef in Brampton. Like, you're all in the same place. I don't know, man.
Bosne.
That's crazy.
Mi smo se dogovorili da se
ne tučemo, da prestanu
bitke u dolini
Neretve. Power that started this beef?
Srba i Hrvata.
Oh wait, hold on. Let me check this map out. Oh, there's actually a place called Serbs in Bosnia. And there's Serbia right here, and then here's Croatia. Serbs, Muslim, cult. Oh, wait, he's religion? Never mind. Yo, y'all explain in the comment section. Before the breakup.
Problem je bio samo u tome što niko nije vodio računa o Bošnjacima, Muslimanima.
Karadžić reported to Serbia's
Bosnian,
president
Milosevic. Okay.
Everything was now in place for them to take over a
it's
large part
now.
Of Bosnia.
I've seen that map.
Predsjednik Milosevic nije smatrao da međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine je nešto presudno. On je govorio kako je Kaligula proglasio svog konja za senatora. I govorio je, ipak konj nije bio senator, prema tome Izetbegović nema državu, iako mu neko to prizna, to nije država.
Milosevic controlled the Yugoslav army, but he was too clever to use it openly against Bosnia. He adopted a more devious approach.
I razmatrali smo šta će se desiti u trenutku kada oni priznaju Bosnu i Hercegovinu i kad nas proglase agresorima, da je naša vojska tamo. Samo Milošević i ja smo o tome razmišljali. Nismo druge uključivali. I ocenili smo da mi moramo da predupredimo njih.
They transferred every Bosnian Serb in the Federal Army to units in Bosnia. This provided Karadžić with an army of 80,000 soldiers, fully trained and equipped. Milosevic could deny responsibility, but he kept his hands on the levers of power.
Mi smo naravno njima kazali da će oni dobiti svaku našu materijalnu pomoć, jer oni nisu imali svoje budžete i kakve mogućnosti da sami nastavi.
The man even killed Mance with his nuts.
Se, organizuju.
Where's that big dick energy, bro? How are you going to send an army to a place
Milosevic
and not show your nuts?
His Serb paramilitaries. Armed by his secret police, led by extreme nationalists from Serbia, they were the specialists in terror.
Mi nikad nismo dobili naređenje, uvijek je to bila molba. Zamoli nas Milošević, zamoli nas Admilo Bogdanović, zamoli nas neki general, recimo Domazetović, neko drugi, kaže treba toliko i toliko dobrovoljaca za to i to mesto i mi skupimo toliko dobrovoljaca.
The first place Milosevic sent the paramilitaries was the city of Bjelina. The Serbs wanted absolute military control there. It was the strategic crossroads of northeast Bosnia.
Enough people died right here, just so they could get that.
It's cool, man.
Oh, this is video, right?
The heavily armed Serbs captured the city in 3 days.
No shit. Oh, man. Look at that.
Then, they rounded up the local activists in the Muslim party.
A vijest se brzo proširile, naravno. Kontradiktorne, nevjerovatne skoro, ali nažalost istinite o tome da se ubija civilno stanovništvo.
The paramilitaries invited one photographer along. His presence did not stop the executions.
Man.
He caught this man's last plea to be allowed to live.
sa ogorčenjem smo saznali što se tamo događalo. I u sebi se kleli da se to više ne smije ponoviti. Pozivam sve građane Bosne i Hercegovine. Ne samo...
Man, Serbia did some snakey sized shit. Be bad. Sorry, no. That's some shiesty shit, man. This will be a long bit. Let me stop talking. This will be a long bit itself.
Kome kojima pripadam, nego Srbe.
Y'all be here for an hour, man.
I pripadnike drugih nacija. Baš sve.
I don't understand war, bro. I will never understand war. Why can't we all share, bro? The Earth's big enough, bro. It really is. And there's enough water where we can make land.
The next morning, the citizens of Sarajevo, in their thousands, took to the streets, demanding peace. They saw the city's tradition of tolerance, more mixed marriages than anywhere else in Yugoslavia, at mortal risk.
Where's this? I was talking.
They occupied the parliament chamber.
Where's Bosnia?
Vlada se raspala. Narod je prepušten sam sebi.
Anarchy, bro.
They opposed the nationalism of both Izetbegović and Karadžić. The Serb leader could watch it all. His office was across the street in the Holiday Inn Hotel.
For sure.
He saw the crowd challenge his right to divide the city and attempt to march on his headquarters.
Damn, they're ready to die.
Ja sam odmah uzeo telefon i javio našoj policiji da mogu očekivati.
They were all willing to die just there. All those people were willing to die for their country.
Mirotvoraca, tako zvanih, jel?
They were tired of the
mirotvorci. I naša policija se obezbijedila da se to ne desi.
Imaš li paket, ti išta?
Don't forget, ugly.
Šta je svima, ali onoliko koliko smo mi uspjeli vidjeti, veoma su ozbiljno priče.
Iza zavjese, iza zavjese!
Six people were killed. In the city center, long an Izetbegović stronghold, his police soon reasserted control. They arrested the Serb snipers in the Holiday Inn. Karadžić and his followers had fled the city and taken to the hills above Sarajevo. Began sporadic mortaring and sniping to show Izetbegović who was boss.
Kada su već zagrmili topovi nad grada, kada se grad već bio počeo, kad je počelo rušenje grada, Krajišnik je ponudio da se nađemo i da se dogovorimo kako je rekao Sarajevo.
They chose the now abandoned parliament building for their secret talk.
Ja sam došao prvi i kad sam došao tu onda je bio jedan mrak.
Mi smo bili prije toga na neki način kao prijatelji smo bili jer smo radili jedno vrijeme u toj skupštini i tako dalje.
Tada sam vidio njihovo obezbeđenje koje su imali automate sa prigušivačima i tako dalje i tako nešto slično. Ja sam rekao, znate, slabo vam je to oružje, u Srba je to mnogo bolje. Jednostavno sam se malo našalio.
On je meni rekao ovako, ne može se izbjeći podjela grada.
Mi smo uvijek razmišljali o podjeli Sarajeva, da bi Sarajevo bilo i muslimansko i srpsko i tu nikakva tajna nije.
Ja podjelu nisam prihvatio. Mi smo se pozdravili, on je mene dao za neku uspomenu jedno pero.
The Serbs hesitated before launching an assault on Sarajevo. Their first objective was to take those parts of Bosnia closest to Serbia itself, no matter who lived there.
Sa stanovišta srpskog naroda za nas je jedino prihvatljivo da smo nezavisni, da niko ne može nad nama da dominira, da brojnost drugog naroda, recimo muslimanskog, nema na nas nikakvog uticaja. Da ne može da odlučuje našu sudbinu koliko procenata muslimana ima. To je naše pravo.
In the territories where Serbs were the majority, they took control. But between Serbia and the Serb areas of Bosnia lay a region where most of the people were Muslim. In each of the principal towns there, Gorajda, Foča, Srebrenica, the local Serb leader gave an order to the Muslim mayor, disarm your police and surrender. Zvornik, the crossing point for the road and rail links between Serbia and Bosnia, also received this order.
Ja bih rekao da ipak ne postoji baš neki poseban razlog da se svije tako stanja u tom broju, niti da izbjegava boravak u Zvorniku, jer narod mora znati da je Srpska demokratska stranka brine o svojim građanima.
But here too the town police had been ordered to lay down their arms. Svornik's Muslim mayor was called in and told the town would be Serb. He had no choice. Muslim mayor was called in and told the town would be Serb. He had no choice.
Nema šansi za nekakvo napadanje Zvornika ni sa jedne ni sa druge strane. Može se živjeti zajedno.
But the man knew that Federal Army tanks had already surrounded his town.
Milošević definitivno preuzima apsolutnu kontrolu i ta zvornička operacija je planirana u Beogradu. U njoj su učestvovale snage bosanskih Srba.
I'm giving him a chance.
I one su bile brojnije. Međutim, specijalne jedinice i najborbenije jedinice došle su s ove strane. To su bile direktno jedinice policije, takozvane crvene beretke. To su specijalne jedinice službe državne bezbednosti Srbije. Tu su bili dobrovoljci Srpske radikalne stranke. Tu su bili Arkanovi dobrovoljci.
Šešel, the paramilitary leader, briefed Serb forces in this hotel. According to the UN War Crimes Commission, he read out the names of leading Muslims in Svornik to be killed. The Serbs launched their attack. The city's defenders were driven out of town within the day. That day, a UN official was driving from Serbia to Bosnia.
Big LMGs.
Jel tako ljudi?
Ja, ništa, čuo sam. Evo imam je na glavi, ko se
ja, ispratnica moram. Da imaju beretke, pomogli bi nam. Ovdje se jedino puca.
That day, a UN official was driving from Serbia to Bosnia. He was stopped just outside Svornik.
Me crucé con un vehículo del Comité Internacional de Cruz Roja que me dijeron, no pases, no pases, tout le monde est fou, everybody is crazy.
A paramilitary commander, proud of his work, let in a news crew. Here, the regime of terror is being established as military police try to identify the Muslims.
Y era un grado de tensión absolutamente terrible y en una de las curvas, antes de ser detenidos, patinamos, el coche se deslizó sobre sangre. Sobre todo había un fuego de artillería muy importante que venía del lado serbio del Drina. Y yo vi incluso el humo que salía de las explosiones que hacen los cañones cuando salen los proyectiles en el lado serbio.
The Serb paramilitaries were mopping up as the UN representative arrived.
Like, where do you go?
Pojste, sami. Čekaj, ovdje. Ovdje, ovdje. Ajde, ovdje,
Hodi ovamo! Napred, ajde, izme!
Ko je pucao sad malo?
Ne znam gdje se mi.
Ko je pucao?
Pa ne znam dok li. Napred!
Operacija je dugo smišljana, dugo spremana, tako da nije ništa bilo u nekoj nervozi da se zove, hajde hitno, treba ovo, treba ono. Sve je bilo dobro organizovano i dobro izvedeno.
Entretanto se veían camiones pasar con cuerpos
de cadáveres. Like...
Vi en varias casas alrededor milicianos sick. Metiendo That's cuerpos sick. De mujeres, niños, ancianos en camiones. Yo vi por lo menos 4 o 5 camiones con cadáveres.
Some 2,000 people were unaccounted for. Nobody knows how many of them were executed on the spot, or how many were sent to concentration camps, where the murder continued. The rest were expelled. 49,000 Muslims lived in Sfornik. None remain. 5 centuries of Islamic life and culture there were erased.
Yo,
this is ethnic cleansing.
No, I didn't hear that right.
49,000 Muslims lived in Sfornik. None remain. 5 centuries of Islamic life and culture there were erased. This is ethnic cleansing. It became routine as the Serbs took control of 3/4 of Bosnia's territory.
All these people are dead.
In time, they learned to keep the cameras out.
All these people are dead.
But ethnic cleansing continued.
Ja ne mogu da kažem da toga nigde nije bilo.
He called it ethnic cleansing.
To je nekada više organizovano ovde u Beogradu.
Look at this guy.
There is no one who can believe what is mentioned as a organized genocide, even organized from Belgrade, and even organized by me. It's really out of all consideration.
I tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci.
Considering the tragic situation in Bosnia and Herzegovina, we have no choice, and our presidency had no choice but to appeal for a military intervention in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Instead, the international community sent a peace envoy, Lord Carrington. He put a proposal to the president: partition Bosnia into ethnic provinces.
Which, of course, isn't what he wanted. What he wanted was a unitary state.
On je rekao, ali dobro, šta ćete raditi? Ja sam rekao da ćemo se boriti. Ovdje bih naglasio tu stvar, tada je Carrington stao na trenutak i rekao, zaustavio se i pogledao me pravo u oči i pitao, kako mislite da se borite?
It was clear to me that the overwhelming military superiority at that time, at any rate, was with the Serbs. And they were obviously being helped. I mean, President Milosevic may have denied it.
A on je meni rekao tada, vi, gospodine Izetbegoviću, ne znate s kim imate posla. Oni imaju nekoliko hiljada tenkova, oni imaju nekoliko stotina borbenih aviona, oni imaju 3 do 4 hiljade artiljerijskih sredstava, oni imaju stokove oružja koje su gomilali 40 godina, jel vi to znate? Pa kako mislite da se oduprete?
You know, in President Izetbegović's position, he was in a very difficult position, there's no doubt whatever about it.
Ja sam rekao da mi nemamo izbora. Mi nemamo izbora, mi nama preostaje jedno da se borimo ili da kapituliramo. Ako kapituliramo, bit ćemo pobijeni.
2 weeks later, the Serbs finally launched their assault on Sarajevo.
We gotta climb down.
A handful of UN peacekeepers had just opened an office there. On the day of the attack, One of them was expecting a package.
Damn.
I sent my administrative clerk downtown. He came back about an hour later and said, I have good news and I have bad news. And I said, what's the good news? He said, I found the post office. Great, what's the bad news? It's no longer there. It's been blown up and everything in it.
Serb saboteurs had destroyed Sarajevo's central post office, knocking out most of the city's phone lines, including those of the Bosnian presidency and defense headquarters.
Live footage too.
3 miles away, the UN's General Mackenzie indulged his passion for home video, even as he asked his soldiers in the city center what exactly he was filming.
Victor Papa, I'm watching the smoke from the downtown area. Can you tell me, is it in the direction of the presidency? Over.
Victor Papa from Victor Charlie 1. Yes, it's in the direction of the presidency. Over.
Sir.
From three directions, the Serb forces, backed up by the tanks and air power of the Federal Army, closed in on the heart of Sarajevo. The city's defenders included local criminal gangs, professional soldiers, even Serbs willing to fight for a multi-ethnic Bosnia.
Kulminacija je dostigla vrhunac onog momenta kada su tri četiri avera prešli most Vrbanja, odnosno most Skenderija i našli su se na svojih 50 metara od skupštine grada i predsjedništva.
Pucalo je na sve strane. I u jednom trenutku moj telohranitelj je rekao da je on korisni da ide da se bori dole negdje iza zgrade, nego da bude sa mnom ovdje. Na taj način čini više pomoći. Shvatio sam da prijeti opasno da se zgrada ne osvoji.
But Sarajevo's narrow streets gave her defenders the edge. Bosnian fighters with anti-tank missiles stopped the Serb armor in its tracks. The Bosnians then turned the tables on the Serbs and encircled the Federal Army's headquarters in the city center.
Jeez, they came back!
Počela borba na život i smrt. Je. Nas je bilo tamo oko 200.
Look at this guy, that's an OG.
70. Komand.
Wow.
Njih je bilo nekoliko hiljada, i hiljade, znate, to je blizu
stranjina. That was on the comeback.
Od 3 metra do 50 metra, tu su oni kredili. To je rulja jedna. To su fanatici.
The two sides had fought to a standstill. The general was surrounded in his own headquarters. Then, within hours, the Serbs would get a chance to finish off Bosnia with a single clean blow to the head. The European community had summoned President Izetbegovic to peace talks.
How long are you going to stay in Lisbon?
They're going to assassinate him.
I think a day only, because I can't be absent from the state more than one day.
Would you agree on a sort of a confederation for both?
We don't accept any confederation in Bosnia.
Don't assassinate while he's talking, bro.
As usual, his daughter was by his side.
Are you going, sorry?
Oh my god.
Ja sam upravo tad se vraćao u Sarajevo. I krenuli smo, zaustavili smo se bili u Limu radi uzimanja goriva. I piloti su provjerili da li imamo clearance za grad, za Sarajevo.
U jednom trenutku je, kako smo se približavali Sarajevu, tu našu laganu atmosferu je prekinuo pilot koji je izašao i rekao da je aerodrom sarajevski zatvoren.
Sarajevo airport had been seized by the Federal Army at the start of the war. It was still under the direct control of Belgrade. To pass through here, President Izetbegovic needed UN protection. General Mackenzie sent an officer to meet him.
And he went out and, if I remember correctly, stayed for about an hour and a half after the scheduled arrival time. But no President Itzebegovich, and no one out there knew anything about when the aircraft was going to arrive or even if it had left.
So the UN officer left the airport, but the president didn't know it.
Prošlo je 5 minuta lijeta, vratio se ponovo taj kopilot i rekao da na sreću imamo ponovo Sarajevo i oni nam kažu da se možemo spustiti na našu odgovornost.
Nije progovarao, onda je zovnuo pilota i rekao sletite u Sarajevo. Mi kad smo sletili, ispred aviona nas je čekao jedan major jugoslovenske armije.
Ja sam pitao gdje su posmatrači, oni kažu, mi ne znamo, oni nisu došli.
Pozvao me general Đurđevac da kaže da se Alijana slepo spustio na Erdu.
The president was now a prisoner of the man his own forces had surrounded, General Kukanjac.
Znate, mene najsmešnije kad neko počne mene da ubeđuje da on više mrzi Aliju Izetbegovića. Nemoj ga mrzeti, ja imam najviše razloga za to. Ali to ne mora da znači da ga likvidirate. Ja sam to zvađića, on je mene rekao, neko ostaje na pristanišnoj zgradi, lepo sam imati odnos, dok ja ne konstatujem predsjedništvo Jugoslavije.
Ja sam, moram reći, bio ovako
iznenađen,
iskreno da budem, nije mi to, nije mi bilo neprijatno i čuti. Ali sam znao da to može imati implikacije i znajući da je naš razgovor što i da se sluša, ja sam mahinalno reagovao i kazao sam pa valjda Blagoje nijesu ga uhapsili, nego su ga zadržali radi njegove lične bezbednosti u kasarni našoj tamo u Kukavici. Ne, uhapsio ga je. Blagoje nije u trenutku vjerovatno shvatio šta ja želim, šta hoću time da kažem i tako dalje.
Izetbegović alone held the government in Sarajevo together. His colleagues there didn't know the army had seized him. Earlier that day, a group of children had been airlifted from Sarajevo. In this chaos, a worried mother, who happened to have one of the few working phones in the city, managed to get through to the airport.
Ko zna kako, ona je došla do broja telefona direktora aerodroma. Ni ona znala ni koga je dobila. Niti on znao ko je ta žena. On je njoj rekao otprilike, jeste gospođo, ne brinite se ništa, vaše dijete je otišlo, ništa, nemate razloga da se brinete. I predsjednik Izetbegović se u tom trenutku digao, prišao direktor je rekao, izvinjam se, hoćete mi dati slušalicu. Izetbegović je uzeo telefon i rekao, najde Slovenije, dobro večer, gospođo. Alija Izetbegović, predsjednik predsjedništva Republike Bosne i Hercegovine, pored telefona. Bila je jedna mala stanka, vjerojatno ona rekla, molim, šta, ko? On je na to rekao, da, da, gospođo, jeste, u pravu ste, da, Alija Izetbegović, predsjednik predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine, na telefon. Vidite, hoćete biti tako dobri, molim vas. Ja sam, znate, ovdje na aerodromu, pa bi vas ja zamolio da zovnete predsjedništvo, da kažete u predsjedništvu da sam s vama razgovarao, da se nalazim ovdje. A ako ne možete da dobijete predsjedništvo, molim vas, zovnite radio televiziju, pa vi jeste radio televiziju da se nalazim ovdje i da me armija ne dozvoljava da dođem ovdje i da traži da idem da vidim generala Kukanjca. Da, gospođo, da, generala Kukanjca. Vjerovatno je žena, jel, sve to slušala i nije mogla da vjeruje. Ona je mahinalno ponavljala to što je o njoj govorio, rekao je on, da, puno vam hvala, da, jeste, eto, upravo tako, hvala lijepo, doviđenja, gospođo, i...
Well, that's wild.
As she got on the phone to Sarajevo television, the army was removing the president to a base in Serb-controlled territory. The evening news staff began phoning round to find him.
I onda moj telohranitelj je ušao i kaže, znate, nešto se događa sa predsjednikom, traži vas s televizije.
Režim javljaju da imamo na telefonskoj liniji predsjednika predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine, Aliju Izetbegovića. I kakav je vaš položaj u Lukavici?
Ja sam ovdje praktički zarobljenik. Ne, evo, general Đurđevac kaže da to nije tako.
Zašto ti ne dođeš u predsjedništvo?
Zašto što mi ne daju da dođem?
O čemu se radi?
Pa ne može to tako, samo trenutak.
Alo, 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 to je istina. Na kom telefonu se ti nalaziš?
Ja, nama su pokidali linije, razumijem.
Kako, kako ste ovi sad uspjeli dobiti?
Pa evo televizije.
Preko televizije, gospodine predsjedniče.
Radio uspostavio ove linije, ovo je preko radija.
Sarajevo watched, amazed. On television, Izetbegović appointed a loyal deputy to take over in case he were killed. Ejup Gunić.
Naravno, to je jedno bilo veliko breme tereta.
Think about how scared you have to be to do all that.
Ali, samo trenutak, molim vas. Suverena javnost prati da je predsjednik predsjedništva jedne suverene i nezavisne države uopšen od armije koja nema legitimitet na ovoj državi. Beograd zna šta je uradio. Molim vas predsjednika, dozvolite predsjedniku da dođe na svoje radno mjesto, pustite ga iz zatvoreništva.
Gospodine generale, nešto moramo da učinimo. Dajte,
moram
molim vas.
Moramo učiniti, gospodin Izetbegović je ovdje. Ali ja molim da nam se malo vjeruje. Mi tražimo da se nama omogući da se izvučemo iz grada Sarajeva.
Imate garanciju predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine da će put koji vi odaberete biti...
Da niko nema autoritete da obuzda ove ljude koji...
Imamo mi
autoritete
i preduvjet je da se... Teritorijalna odbrana sluša predsjedništvo.
Dobro, to čuješ. Dadnite tako upustvo TO-u.
Da ćemo pate pustvo te ovo, međutim, mi ne može država...
Ja imam dovoljno jake nerve.
Mada je on hrabar čovjek, međutim, poseban problem je predstavljala činjenica da je njegova kćerka sa njim.
Mislim da je to bila jedina noć kada nisam uopće spavao. Na drugom kraju kancelarije je bio veliki neki sat vojnički. Ja se sjećam, ja sam stajao, ležao prema tom satu. Ja sam vidio kako izbija 12 sati, pola, 1, 2, 3, 4 ujutro, 5 ujutro, ja nisam spavao. Razlog je jer su mi kćerku bili odveli. Ja sam od te kćerke ostao u strašnoj brizi.
The new deputy president telefoned the federal army commander and warned him not to harm Izetbegović.
Ja mu kažem, Milutine, sve je zatvorno oko tebe. Ptica ne može izaći, ispod tebe je prokopan tunel, nemoj se igrati sa glavom.
Naredite prekid vatre ili će, bojim se, svašta biti.
Look at this guy.
Vodi računa.
This guy was ready, this guy was going around killing everybody, not giving a fuck.
Da izađeš, dogovorit ćemo se za tvoje vojnike, ti znaš da smo sarađivali. Smiri se, Milutine, jedna mala greška, ideš u zrak do Trbevića.
Jeez.
They agreed to a meeting at first light in UN headquarters between the Bosnian government and the army.
He was about the shits.
He was
tired of it.
Gospodine generale, nemate zemlje u svetu gdje je predsjednik zemlje, zvanično izabrane zemlje, uhapšen od vojske.
Kakva je to armija koja predsjednika jedne države kidnapuje?
Ali nema ni zemlje u svijetu gdje je komandant armije i komanda armije napadnuto od tog istih snaga tog predsjednika. Prema tome, ako ćemo razgovarati, možemo o jednovremenom puštanju i komandant armije i komanda armije iz Sarajeva, da dođe u Lukavicu, i gospodina Izetbegovića. Ganić odmah skočio, ne, predsjednik je predsjednik, ovo ćemo raditi, ne.
I was lobbying that we do an exchange of the two individuals and that was deemed to be a good way to start.
I dogovoreno da se pokanci može poći mogu poći njegovi telohranitelji dva ili tri saradnika.
He wasn't with it! You can't kidnap our president and think I'm just gonna let you give us back our mans and we're not gonna shoot. No, once you give us, we're not gonna go and blow your heads off.
General McKenzie videoed the two negotiators as they phoned the army base to report what had been agreed.
Guys, what the shit? Alright, oh shoot. Alright, we back. I gotta meet Frank Stockhead.
Okay, samo tamo sam. Kako ti gledaš?
Halo. A što ti je? Ovako, ovdje na dogovoru pred Evropom i sve, no, dogovorili smo se.
UN. What if the UN wasn't there, what would have happened?
General McKenzie rushed off to the army base to collect Izetbegović.
Okay, the UN troops are coming in now.
The deputy president that was smart, bro. Headquarters.
If that lady didn't call,
if he could keep his side of the bargain.
Bro, if that lady didn't call, him getting to the radio station, remember, all the phone lines were down. may not have happened. This war could have went a little crazier. You killed the head state guard. Oh my god, this would have got nasty. And it was already got nasty. Mass erasing, what do you call it? Ethnic cleansing? Oh my god. How do you come up with a proper term for killing off a race? A generation? That's crazy shit, bro. Imagine if that lady didn't call the chicken for her kid. Shit could have went left. Like,
Hitler
type left.
Il m'a dit je suis pas sûr, j'ai peur.
It would have went, Mads would start kidnapping people and it would have went too much. Look how bad it is already.
General McKenzie se pojavi u tih sati gore u posredovanju da se ja oslobodim.
But before McKenzie could leave the base, the army upped their demand. They now wanted their entire headquarters staff brought out of the city center.
Why would you say that the first time?
There's no way I can look after a convoy. I can only look after individuals. And the president said, not to worry. I will guarantee the security of the convoy.
But while he was sitting inside a UN armored vehicle, the president could guarantee nothing. His deputy was in charge.
Of course.
General McKenzie nije obavijestio šta se događa. Došlo je do neke vrste haosa.
McKenzie's plan was to drive Izetbegović through the Serb-held territory and then through the Bosnian government forces to the army headquarters.
They would
pick up General Kukanjac and his men. The president and the general would lead the army convoy to the front line near the Bosnian presidency. Then the captives would be received by their respective forces.
Well, of course.
The president was reunited with his daughter. They set off through the streets which had, the day before, seen vicious fighting.
Vidio sam uništene tenkove sa strane koje stoje, sam gledao kroz nekakve, kroz male prozore na ovom transporteru.
There were tanks burning, there were engines blown out of vehicles sitting in the middle of the road. There were bodies, many of them in fact looked like they were sunning themselves. It was a very, very nasty, nasty scene.
Shit, look at that, man. He's rotten, he's burnt.
The president arrived at army headquarters where General Kukanjac and his men were waiting.
If he died, it would have went left.
The troops were frantically loading their lorries, confident they had been granted safe passage.
Yeah, they thought.
President, did you arrange for the evacuation?
No statement.
Okay, please.
Ali niko nije dao saglasnost na oružje, arhiva, svi vojnici mogu izaći, to je ostalo da se rešava kasnije.
With General McKenzie's white UN car in the lead, the convoy headed out. It was surrounded on all sides by Bosnian government forces eager for revenge.
No shit.
Ti ljudi koji su nalaze u konvoju, oni su prethodni dan komandovali sa granatiranjem i pucanjem po Sarajevu. Oni su bili u komandi koja je rukovodila oružanom borbom. Oni su htjeli da zauzmu Sarajevo. Ta reakcija građana i boraca na prostoru Skenderije bila spontana i tada dolazi do presjecanja kolone.
I believe a red Volkswagen Golf had driven across an intersection and blocked and split the convoy into two.
In the armored vehicle, General Kukanjac hid, but President Izetbegović peered out to see his fighters ambush the trucks behind him and seize the army's equipment.
There were Bosnian army folks with their weapons pointed in the back of the trucks and the equipment was coming out very, very quickly.
Na sve strane se pucalo.
Quick!
Sam vidio generala Divjaka.
Quick!
Bravo, Divjak, bravo!
It came out quick!
Pokušava da smiri tu pucnjevu. Ali
you can't take the government, man. You're gonna come out freely. They thought they were too much. They were feeling themselves.
Tada sam pozivao pripadnike teritorijalne odbrane da se ne otvara vatra, da je predstavnik insistirao da se ovaj problem reši bez oružanog sukobljavanja.
Yo man, the government's people like that?
President Zabegovic stood up, very calm, not in the least bit panicky. General Kukanyets didn't look terribly happy.
Ja sam imao oružje, pištolj.
He was ready. This guy was ready to shoot.
Da ubijem Aliju I sebe.
Kukanyets held his fire.
He was gonna go out. The president and General Divjak radioed
their headquarters and ordered the ambush lifted. They faced mutiny.
I take out two, take out five, I'm straight. Why are some nice people, bro? Imagine all them deaths and they still trying to not kill these people. Or like capture them or nothing, like mutilate them and shit.
Sutra se nas svaki sat je jedno pola sata obavljen razgovor sa predsjednikom.
Govori Divjak da se predsjednik dovede u predsjedništvo, da se kolona pusti.
To vrijeme još uvijek nije bila ustrojena. Armija niti je moglo naše narođenosti da svako pojedince.
The local Bosnian commanders went back along the convoy, quieting people down, calming them down, and people, poof, disappeared.
The president made it home. The Serbs, who had nearly extinguished both him and his state, now set siege to his capital. Bosnia became a member of the UN, but nobody would help her take control of her own territory.
Hell's a dead body.
There will be no unilateral use of United States force. As we have said before, we are not and we cannot be the world's policemen.
Milosevic sent the Bosnian Serbs a new general to run their army, Ratko Mladic. This is what he ordered for Sarajevo.
General Mladic.
Da, izvolite.
Bez panike, ko si ti prvo?
Vukašinović.
Jesam. Pukovnik.
Jesam.
Direktnim pogodcima držite pod vatrom predsjedništvo I skupštinu. I tucite polako u intervalima dok ja ne naredim da se prekine.
Razumem.
That's a fucked up. Wait, is there a part two? Did they just end like that? What kind of doc was this? Nah, I gotta look for a part two or something. I don't know, man. Oh, man. How was that? Yeah, she didn't know. Yeah, damn. I don't even know how it ended. I'm, like, so befuddled right now. Holy shit. Alright, you guys already know what it is. Show in the comment section how you feel about this. You guys know what happened, how it ended, anything that you feel like I'm missing that's or it's going to aid me to understand this a little better, put in the comments section. This is fun, bro. Man, war is a nasty place, man. War is just something different. I'm so empty right now. I gotta go look for like a part two or something that's going to explain like the ending of this, because it cannot end like this. But you guys already know, go to my Instagram if you guys want any suggestions. Hit me up in the DMs after you follow me. Till next time. Oh, yeah, if you're new to the channel, like, share, and subscribe. Or did I already say that? I don't know. But I gotta go search for a part two or something. All right, until next time. Call me like a witch, bitch, limp dick, put it on your daughter, and still call it a nut. Patty K, none of you bitch like Johnny K. ATL pull up in a roller skates, work my song like a library.